Alright, welcome back guys to another episode with the Prelude. Today we're going to be changing the 5-3 rubber brake lines to these braided steel lines from Stoptech. And then, now the reason why you would want to do this is to change the 5-3 rubber lines, which is this one, to the Stoptech one, because over time these rubber lines, they expand and they decrease brake pedal feel. This upgrade is not very expensive, and it offers a great increase in performance and safety. Now, I just did right there. These are the stated steel braided lines from Stoptech. You could tell the difference between this one and this one. This one looks like it already expanded. And the reason why you want to do this is just to decrease brake pedal travel and increase performance. Now, Stoptech offers these steel lines for many cars and models, so they're available for many vehicles. And these lines come as a set for each axle. So in the bag comes two lines. It comes with all the bolts that you're gonna need, the banjo bolt, and even a bleeder screw grommet. It comes with the copper gasket as well, and you're gonna torque this to a different spec than the factory ones. You're not gonna torque it as tight, I believe. So we already removed this, and you can see all the fluid that is yellow and old in the bin. So we're gonna also be replacing the fluid with Motul brake fluid to also increase performance and decrease brake travel as well. All right, so I'm gonna teach you how to remove this factory rubber line on this Honda. I just unbolted this the steel braided line, the steel line, and next we're going to take off this clip so that we can unlock the line and also continue taking it off. You're going to get some pliers, you're going to grab the clip. Make sure that you pull it off. Do not damage it, because you're gonna be reusing this again. Also, make sure you put something on the bottom so the brake fluid is gonna leak. It leaks not on the floor. Next, we're gonna unbolt this bolt right here. It's a 10 mil. Next, we're gonna remove the banjo bolt, factory one. As you can see, all the fluid is leaking out. So, you just wanna remove it here, and that's how you remove the factory line. Pretty straightforward. And just try to get the other steel braided line on there so that you can prevent running the brake master cylinder dry. We're gonna replace the fluid, as I said, but you don't want to run the master cylinder dry. So like I said before, you want to bolt this down first. You then want to bolt this straight to the steel line, the steel brake line. Just bolt it in place just so it could catch some thread. I'll also clean the threads as well. and then you want to bolt the banjo bolt in place as well. All right, so what you're gonna wanna do is torque it to the 14 foot-pounds. Now for me, I have an inch-pounds torque wrench. So I converted it and it's 168 inch-pounds. So I set it. Now we're gonna torque it down. Alright, so when you install it, this is basically how it's supposed to be. I just suggest that you put this bolt in first for the bracket, then you can slide this into place and then put the banjo bolt here. Now the banjo bolt, you're not, it says to torque it down to the factory spec for this Honda. On other cars, I believe it's not. I think it's less. So just make sure you read the directions on the slip that you get, and that way you know how to put the bolt correctly and torque it down correctly, just to be safe. Make sure this is tight, and I used two copper gaskets on the banjo bolt at the bottom. Alright, so we're gonna do the back steel lines. Again, we're removing this, so just spray it down with WD-40. And before you even start trying to unbolt this, leave the clip inside. If you take the clip out, it's gonna be incredibly hard to take it off, especially on this Honda. So leave the clip, spray it down with WD-40, and then we're gonna just remove all the bolts, the bracket bolts and the banjo bolt that's right here. Alright, this is the reason why you want to spray WD-40 on it. You can see all the gunk and stuff that has accumulated as the wheel, you know, turns and you drive the car. That's gonna seize that up. So as soon as you spray WD-40 on it, it's gonna be a lot smoother to just unbolt it. And then once you get it off, you want to spray brake clean and clean that off before you thread it back onto a new brake line. Alright guys, so this is the Motul .4 racing brake fluid that we're going to change. This car most likely has .3. I've never changed it, so that's why we're going to change it to .4. Now the reason why you want to change it is because this has a higher boiling point than most brake fluid, and that's why it's called racing brake fluid. Because if you're, let's say, racing on the track, you're going to be stepping on the pedal a lot more often, and it's gonna heat up all that fluid and the brakes and the discs themselves. But in case of the fluid, this is not gonna boil and cause like more brake pedal travel. It's not gonna be very mushy, it's gonna be stiff. So that's what you want with a firm brake pedal, and that's why we're gonna change to this, and I'll upgrade the lines as well. All right, guys, so we just put the Motul racing fluid in. We bleeded the brakes, as you can see. You should end on the brake closest to the reservoir and begin from the furthest. So we began from the rear right, then we went to the left right, right front, right front, and then left front. The fluid is supposed to come out clear with no bubbles in it at all. That's how you know you don't have air in the system. And I want to show you what we have in the bottle. All right, so this is what all the dirty fluid we got out of the system. It's quite a lot. Some of it has debris because the bottle was dirty. But most of it, all the black fluid that you see, that's all old dirty fluid. That's why we had to bleed the brakes. So hopefully you guys enjoyed watching, and I will see you guys next time.